Hey you guys, it's Peter, and I'm back. Of course I'm back, I'm not going anywhere. Beast. I'm YouTube famous now. Available in 2020, the album Dad AF. Rock on, gold dust woman. I just got home from doing a review of Joella's vegan chicken. You wanna know what I thought? Well, you're gonna have to go watch my review video. But before we do, let's have a little bit of coffee before we talk about the drama up in the kitchen, up in Martika's kitchen, Peter's kitchen. I just went and got my coffee too. And if you don't know, I do a lot of Starbucks reviews over my review channel. I'm having such a blast over there. Please go check it out. It's called Peter Reviews Stuff. It's listed below. It's a lot of food, a lot of culottes, cotton candy culottes from Dunkin' Donuts, Starbucks drinks, all kinds of things as seen on TV stuff. I'm just having a blast over there. So thank you to all of you that have come over there and subbed and said you like that channel. I really appreciate it. Today I would like to talk about Jaclyn Hill. And I would like to talk about the fact that Jaclyn Hill is trying to reemerge into social media and that she just can't catch a break. It doesn't seem like she can catch a break in what she's putting out there. And I want to just kind of have an open conversation about it. I will say my piece. You guys put your piece in. Put your piece, okay? Put it in the comment section. Leave it there. Your piece, okay? Peace. So anyway, I want to talk about what we think that she should do moving forward, you know? I mean, what can she do at this point? And I have a couple of suggestions for her, you know? What's interesting, what's interesting to me is that Jaclyn is like putting out a tweet and then she's liking several of the responses. And then when it gets kind of ugly, she kind of gets a little pissed about it, right? Well, here's the thing that's surprising to me about that is that I have watched Jaclyn now, I don't know, off and on for a couple years, but she's been around for like 8-10 years on YouTube at this point. And the thing that's surprising to me about it is that she, you would think, would be used to the hate at this point. So why is she engaging in the hate? Like, that is what I don't understand about it. By the way, did you see that John Hill put a picture up on Instagram? I think it was yesterday or the day before. I got sent this by so many people. And he said something about trying to find a side job and what, you know, should he do as a side job. And somebody underneath there put, go work for Jaclyn or something like that, or Jaclyn Cosmetics. And he put, no thanks, dot, dot, dot. I thought they were good Judy's and they were getting along. I don't know what happened with all of that. But anyway, you know, Jaclyn's putting out all these tweets, and it seems like she just cannot catch a break, right? And I was talking to a friend of mine about this, and I was like, what do you think that needs to happen? We were talking about what we think needs to happen for her to move forward, for her to move on, and that people are going to forget this. Well, the reality is this, okay, is that first she needs to accept that people are never going to forget this. There are going to be a certain amount of people that are never going to forget what happened with the lipsticks. They're just not. It's going to be ever-present for as long as she posts videos. Again, there is going to be a certain segment of people on YouTube that are never going to forget this, okay? And then the next thing is that she needs to handle her business. A lot of the business still has not been handled. When you go underneath any tweet, there is just constant tweets in there from people saying, what about my refund? Will I be getting my refund before December, blah, blah, blah. What, hold on a second. Somebody has a question. It's Pee-Pee the Flying Chihuahua. What do you wanna know? You haven't gotten your Jaclyn Hill refund yet? He said, I don't even care. So anyway, but a lot of people are saying they still haven't gotten the refund. Have they really not gotten the refund? Are they just saying that they haven't gotten the refund to stir up trouble? Who knows at this point, right? But like that part is gonna always be there. I think for her to reemerge herself on social media, first of all, she needs to start posting more videos, okay? You can't come back and say, I wanna get back to what I love, which is posting videos, and then not post videos, right? Like people are giving you second and third chances, Jaclyn, and they're going by what you're saying, and then you're like, oh, I wanna come back to YouTube and do what I love, which is tutorials and reviews and posting videos, and then you come back and you post like one video that you have pre-filmed and then another video, and that's it, in all of this, right? And so it's like, you gotta start posting some videos, Jaclyn, like if you wanna be known for that again, and not just when you're ready to, put out another product, you have to be putting out videos because that's what people want to see from Jaclyn is they want to see her return to YouTube, you know? The faster that Jaclyn, she's taking her break. We already know that, okay? She's out there, she's living her life, she's taking her break. The faster that she gets back to uploading YouTube videos on a regular basis, and for regular basis, I would say to her, 2 to 3 times a week. Not what she was doing before all this, but 2 to 3 times a week, okay? You know, she could do, I know she said she don't want to do her boyfriend in all these videos or whatever, but she could do something with her friend or her sister or, I don't know, do a Q&A and, you know, not answer the questions about the lipsticks, and then 50 drama channels would make videos and say, Jaclyn avoided all questions, you know, whatever. But she could come back and do anything. There are a ton of things for her to review. You know, there are a ton of things for her to show, you know, and do like, I don't know, she did like the drugstore thing, but then she's, of course, pushing Morphe again, and it's like, okay, this is what's so frustrating to me about Jaclyn saying, like, I want to move on, I want to learn, whatever. She isn't listening to what anybody is saying. That's the problem here, right? And so people are listening to what she's saying, but they're basing what they're going to do next on her action, which is why she's starting to lose subscribers. Because what she said was, I want to get back to what I love, I want to get back to what I'm doing, but she's not posting regular videos, and when she does, she's pushing Morphe, and she's pushing Morphe on her Instagram again. I'm baffled by this, right? When you said before the lipstick scandal came out that you weren't going to push Morphe anymore, and then she's pushing Morphe again, right? And I think people are just like, her word is no good. Like, nothing that she says is believable at this point, right? Which is why people are so frustrated with her. This is a point for Jaclyn to come out and show how she's grown as a person by posting videos, by not pushing Morphe products left and right, you know? And listen, and if that's her income and that's how she's making a lot of money is support through Morphe, then be transparent and say that in a video and say, I believe in Morphe, okay? You know, I like make a lot of money from Morphe and I really believe in their products, you know? I do not have a problem getting on video and doing a sponsorship or whatever of a product that I really, really believe in. For example, the teas that I just did. I swear by those teas. I drink those teas. I love them. So I have no problem getting on here. Do you all think I'm not making some money off that when I say it's a sponsored video? Why can't she just be transparent about it? I mean, I don't understand why we have to live in this world on YouTube of influencer illusion. It's ridiculous to me, right? So if you want to push Morphe, just come out and say, I'm going to continue to push this. I really believe in their products. I love their products. They've been very, very good to me, and I make a lot of money off of it. Beast, okay? It's just not that deep. So now she's come out on Twitter, and she's kind of re-emerging herself on Twitter. I have a feeling something's gonna, the other night she started tweeting like, it was like every 2 hours and it was just random stuff. And I was watching it, I was like, what's going on here, you know? Like, why is she all of a sudden getting real active in Twitter? I think what's gonna happen again is, and she needs to be careful because I think she's proven to herself that she can't handle a lot of this. You know, she has been somebody that has been so loved for so long that now she's getting a lot of negative. I don't think she really honestly knows what to do with it. I really don't believe that she knows what to do with people not liking her. I think it's hard, you know? And on that, as a human, I can totally feel for her how hard that must be. But I have to believe that after so much time on YouTube, she knows how to deal with the hate comments. And there's hate comments that are cruel. Okay, for example, she has said that she's gained weight. People are picking apart her pictures. People are saying all this kind of stuff about her gaining weight, right? That's cruel, okay? That just is. Well, that's body shaming. Why are we doing that? There's no reason to do that, okay? But when people continue to ask questions about the refunds for the lipsticks or what happened with the lipsticks and she hasn't addressed it, like she said she was going to address it, well, that's a valid concern and that's something different. And if she's choosing not to address it, like I said in my last video, that she's gonna go forward and she's just not going to address it anymore, then she just needs to take the flack that's gonna go along with it. And she needs to keep on posting, put out videos, and over time, this is what I really think is gonna happen, okay? I get the first question, like when people see me, the first question they ask me is, I mean, this is hilarious, right? That I get asked so much about Jaclyn Hill and they're like, what do you really think is going to happen with Jaclyn Hill? This is what I really think. I mean, not every person I meet on the street, like when I'm driving through Starbucks, they're not like, Jaclyn Hill, what do you think is going to happen? But when I meet people and they like watch my channel, they're like, what do you really think is going to happen with Jaclyn Hill? This is what I really think is going to happen. I think that people are going to continue to invest in her a little bit and watch her. I think she's going to continue to get the negativity over the lips. I think she's going to put out a video here, put out a video there, put out a video here. I think she's going to keep on complaining that people are mean to her. And then what's going to happen is Jaclyn Cosmetics is going to release another product. Everybody's going to buy this product because they're going to want to see if it's such a fail like the lipsticks were. But it won't be this time. Because she has been showing pictures of her and her team flying places and doing all this kind of stuff, right? So she's gonna make sure that whatever product comes out next is absolute perfection. And people are gonna buy it. It's gonna sell out because people are gonna guarantee that it's gonna be a fail. It's gonna be another Jaclyn Cosmetics fail. But it won't be. It'll be a success. And then she'll be able to bank her future on that success. And then people will slowly forget about the lipsticks because it'll be her second release, right? And people will remember the second release, and then slowly that first release of those lipsticks will be like, well, I learned. I learned everything that you guys had to say. I heard about your concerns, blah, 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 whatever. And now I'm moving forward. She really hasn't lost a whole lot. I mean, and the thing about Jaclyn is that she, and she, I think she knows this, she has really, really diehard fans, right? And the people that are unsubscribing to her that are diehard fans are the ones that are disappointed. They're saying, I'm disappointed in you, you know? Well, that is hard to hear from somebody that I'm, it's not, I don't like you, blah, 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 whatever, you're a scammer, like all of that, those are, it is what it is, right? But to have somebody that loved you say they're disappointed in you is hard. So when she comes back and she has a successful launch of whatever it's going to be, and people are really excited about it, and then everybody's buying it and they're loving it, and nobody has any complaints about it, well, those people that were disappointed will fall in love with Jaclyn again. It's not going to really hurt her. I think the long term, I think she's going to be fine. I really, really do, and I think she'll continue to grow. I don't think she knows that right now. I think she's scared. I think she doesn't really know what to do next, which is why I think, okay, the thing is that Jaclyn could literally put out a heart on Twitter and everybody would come for her. And they would say, oh, I love you, but I haven't gotten my refund. Or is that a heart? Does that heart have hairs on it? I mean, it doesn't matter what she tweets out, right? Knowing that, Jaclyn should tweet out whatever she wants to tweet out and not worry about the response that she's going to get. She should tweet it out and not stay on Twitter and respond to it. I just don't think she should. I think one of the biggest problems these influencers have is that they are constantly on Twitter. Like when, I just don't get on Twitter that much. I just don't. And when I get on there and I see it's like, you know, tweet, tweet, tweet. I mean, it's just like they're constantly on Twitter and interacting and seeing all this kind of stuff. You know, it was like one of the things that was interesting to me was that James Charles, when he did the video with Joey Graceffa, this was something I wanted to mention that I didn't say, was when he did the video with Joey Graceffa, he was talking about when you go to a comment, like a negative comment on your video, and let's say, I don't know what number he said, but it was something like 350, and you have 350 likes, like down, or like agree, they agree with that negative comment or whatever, right? That it's the same 350 people over and over again. How do you know? How do you know what 350 people it is over and over and over again, okay? I mean, I have no idea. I don't go through my comments like that, and I do read almost every single comment, and if you watch my vlog channel, you know, it's hard for me to keep up with comments on 5 different channels, so I don't respond to those comments, but not often. I try to pick out days to do it. But the thing is that I don't know who's consistently leaving me negative comments on my main, I mean, and especially if you're getting millions of views, how do you know the same 350 people? Okay, that means you're taking a lot of time and effort instead of working on your next project and being creative and all this kind of stuff and making sure that refunds are being made and all this kind of stuff. You're consumed with social media. Get off social media and run your business, okay? You guys have businesses, your brands, like, I don't understand it, you know, for people like tweet something out and then, you know, like this is what is baffling to me is that Jaclyn tweets something out and then she doesn't expect that people are going to be upset with her still. People are still really upset with you, Jaclyn, and you really haven't given them the answers that they want. You know, some people you have, but other people are like, no, there's a lot of answers I want still. So for example, if you go in here, 3 days ago, she posted a picture of Demi Lovato coming out of, I think it's like a pool or a hot tub or something like that. And she said, so inspired by her. Her post was beautiful, a true model, an icon. And then people in here are very supportive of her and say they love Demi Lovato and all this kind of stuff. And people are saying this and whatever. But then it goes in there and it's stuff about the receipts or stuff about the refunds again, right? And then someone else, then she tweeted out, this was 2 days ago. She said, did anyone else hear that Rihanna is dropping an album in December? My husband is texting me. Hold on a second. Give me. Okay. And then she said, did anyone else hear that Rihanna is dropping an album in December? And then someone said, Adele too, Jaclyn. And then she said, it goes through here and she responds to this other person. And then someone said, will we be getting our refunds before or after Rihanna's new album? And then somebody puts like the dead, you know, faces. And then someone said, no, but I'm still waiting on my refund. And then, I mean, it just goes on and on and on. And then somebody says, STFU, family! family friendly. We don't use that language over here. We didn't forget about your moldy lipsticks. We didn't forget about your moldy lipsticks just yet. Don't try to divert, right? And then somebody else says, I agree we should hold her accountable for her actions and never financially support her again. But I think never financially support her again. That's a pretty blatant statement. But I think she's still allowed to be a person who has thoughts and feelings. And then someone else says she has a feeling, she's a human with feelings. Also, always remind her of her mistakes and always never support her on any projects. But she's a human with feelings. Wow, just wow. And I kind of agree with that, right? Like, so you screw up once, you're never allowed to do another, listen, I've screwed up many, many times in my life, and I've always learned from my mistakes. I haven't learned a whole lot from my successes. I've learned a lot more from my mistakes, and I'm a true believer that you have to fall on your face to get back up. I believe that Jaclyn can do that. I hope that she can. The thing that is, you know, she put in here a picture of her. It looks like she's a sleep apnea machine. I don't know what it is. She says, me after 8 minutes of not getting attention, and she's got a Chanel blanket on. And people say, people are literally waiting for the refunds, but okay. And somebody says, you're so canceled. Like, what? Where's the refunds? And then somebody else says, me 10 years after not getting my... I'm reading these straight down, you guys. Me 10 years after not getting my refund. And then someone else says, everyone on here talking about waiting on the refund, but I got mine months ago. And then somebody responds and says, good for you. Some of us haven't. And then Spill's son, who is like T-Spill's like number one fan account, she goes underneath here, or he goes underneath her, whoever it is, literally in every tweet of Jaclyn's and says, unblock T-Spill. I mean, they put more than that, but like they said, want some attention? Unblock T-Spill. And then somebody put, and I oop. LMFAO, people waiting for the refund, and it just goes on and on and on, right? And so, you know, it's like people are really still wanting to know, what have they not got their refund? Like, this is what I would like to know, okay? In all honesty, don't just do it for attention, but if you truly have not gotten your refund, will you put a comment in the comment section below and say, yeah, I haven't gotten my refund, and I've reached out to them, this is what I did, and I still haven't gotten my refund? I would really like to know that, you know? And then Jaclyn Hill goes underneath here again, and so then she said, she does this whole thing about should she get shoes or handbags. You can only pick one and you can have an endless amount. And underneath here, people are like, shoes, handbags, we want our refund, we want our refund. And she says, I cannot believe how many of you are saying shoes, you are my people. Okay, and then she goes up here and she posts this picture that somebody said, what happened to your face? People are speculating that she got more fillers or that she's gained a lot of weight. She said she's gained some weight. And she says, I gained weight! All caps. Okay, now if you're a millennial, then you already know this. But if you're not, if you're old like me, all caps means shouting, okay? I gained weight! Can you guys please stop body shaming? I don't even want to log onto social media recently because all I see is comments about looking fat and accusing me of getting fillers. Dear God, thank the Lord I have a good support system and self-confidence. And I think that's great that she has good confidence. You know, I think body shaming is really cruel. I don't think there's any reason for it on here, but you're gonna get it. And this is the thing, okay? People, listen, people say things to me like, your voice causes me cancer, okay? I mean, people say really shitty things, okay? And I don't, family friendly, but people really do say really cruel things. I get a gamut, okay, of all of the cruel comments. But they don't really mean a whole lot to me anymore, right? I think the comments that hurt the most are the ones from people that truly do love you and they, you know, critique you in a positive way. I'm not really sure why she's letting all the hate. I do think this is the thing, you know? And it was interesting because Raw Beauty Christie commented underneath here and she said, I've got a good bit of extra weight on me. Girl, me too. You know, listen, okay? I just did a chicken review. Let's just be for real. A vegan chicken review. I've got a good bit of extra weight on me, so I get lots of constant comments about it. Blocking words that are related is very helpful to filter out the a-holes, and my husband deletes the extra mean ones before I can read them. Maybe that can help. Sorry, people are so mean. You know what it is? And then somebody speculates underneath here, do you think it maybe it's a beauty community? And Chrissy says, I think you're probably right. The beauty space comments are sometimes harsh as hell. There's somewhat of a standard people expect, and when your appearance even slightly differs from that, it comes from hideously hurtful comments. Well, I get a lot of comments from the Westboro Baptist Church, so they're blocked on my channel. But other than that, I mean, it's like, you know, I get the old man of YouTube. Why do you let grandpa on here? God, you're so old. Why are you in this? Blah, 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 blah. Why do you sound like a valley girl, but you look like an old man? I get all these comments, and you know what? I don't really care. Kick rocks, okay? Why are you watching my video if you don't like me? that's what I don't understand, you know? And of course you're gonna have haters that watch your video, but those are people that are just watching your videos because they really, really hate you. Don't pay them any mind, okay? My mother always taught me, don't value the opinion of someone you don't value to begin with. And if you value your haters more than your lovers, then what you are doing as a passion on YouTube and making makeup and all of this is completely misplaced, okay? I do feel really bad that Jaclyn is getting these harsh comments. She doesn't deserve it. Nobody deserves those comments. You don't deserve them. I don't deserve them. She doesn't. Christy doesn't. Nobody deserves harsh criticism like that when it comes to somebody's looks and their physicality and their family and things like that. And people on the internet step way over their boundaries with that. But we know that, right? We know that. That doesn't make it right. It doesn't make it right at all, but we know that. So I don't know what she's going to do. I think if she's going to go forward, she's going to have to, you know, continue to post things. You know, today she posted that she woke up with a lot of anxiety and she actually got a lot of really supportive things on there. But then again, people went underneath there and talked about the lipsticks, the lipsticks, the lipsticks. She's just gonna get that for a while. I said this in my video a while ago with Jaclyn, I'm gonna say it again. My best advice to Jaclyn would be, post your tweets, post your videos, don't read the comments, move on for a while. Don't read the thread or let somebody like Christy said, her husband, you know, handle it for you and just post it and learn to be able to enjoy your space again of what you're doing, you know? I'll be real interested to see what happens down the road. She's either going to completely exit off this platform because she can't handle it, and that's my fear. You know, yeah, she screwed up with the lipsticks. Let's just be for real about this, okay? Jaclyn screwed up with the lipsticks. I don't think anybody denies that. Jaclyn still has not given people the answers they want, and people are still complaining that they haven't gotten their refund. There's so much that is wrong with Jaclyn Cosmetics that has not been addressed, okay, by Jaclyn or the company. But that being said, as a human being, Jaclyn deserves to move on. She deserves to have other chances and whatever. And I know there's a lot of people that are like, I'm done with her. I'm never going to give her another chance. I understand that. I'm not saying to buy her products. I'm not saying not to buy her products. I'm not saying as a YouTuber, only you can make that decision. But to Jaclyn, if she were sitting in front of me, I would say, gal, you deserve to continue to do what you love. And hopefully you'll learn from the lessons from the past, you know? And when you fell on your face and you got back up, hopefully you learn from some of that, you know? I hope that for all of us. I hope that for me. I hope that for you. I hope that for all of us. I want to continue to learn on a daily basis and grow. And I hope that for Jaclyn too. And in all honesty, I hope every single one of you gets your refunds. I hope every single one of you gets the answers that you want. And I hope that Jaclyn Hill is successful in her future. Why would you want any less for somebody? I love you guys, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.